Hello friends, now we'll discuss another chromatographic technique which is widely used for purification and separation method, that is affinity chromatography. It is a separation and purification technique that exploits the unique property of extremely specific biological interaction of matrices with analyte. Theoretically, with affinity chromatography, it is possible to achieve absolute purification in a single step from a complex of mixture. Technique was originally developed for purification of enzymes. Later, same methodology was used for purification of nucleotide, nucleic acid, immunoglobulin, membrane receptor, and even to whole cell and cell fragments. Biological interaction between ligand and target molecule is a result of different types of interactions. For instance, electrostatic interaction, hydrophobic interaction, van der Waals force, or hydrogen bonding. To elute target molecule from affinity medium, the interaction can be reversed either specifically using competitive ligand or non-specifically by changing the pH, ionic strength or polarity. The technique requires that material to be isolated is capable of binding reversibly to specific ligand that is attached to insoluble matrices. Under the correct experimental condition, when complex mixture containing specific compound to be purified is added to immobilized ligand packed in a conventional chromatographic column, bundly compound will bind to ligand and all other compound will be washed away and compound subsequently recovered by displacement from the ligand as shown in figure 1, which we'll discuss in detail later. However, method requires detailed preliminary knowledge of structure and biological specificity of the compound to be purified so that separation conditions that are most likely to be successful may be carefully planned. For example, in case of enzyme, ligand may be substrate or competitive reversible inhibitor or allosteric modifier. Condition chosen would normally be those that are optimal for enzyme ligand binding. Now, in typical affinity chromatographic technique, matrices, spacer arm and immobilized ligand are the three main components present in the column. We will discuss about properties of matrices, spacer arm and ligand one by one. Matrices. It is an important component of conventional affinity chromatographic technique. It should have following characteristics. For instance, it must possess suitable and sufficient chemical group to which chemical may be covalently coupled or may be stable under conditions of attachment. That means there should be an appropriate condition in which matrices can bind to ligand. Further, it should be stable during binding of macromolecule and its subsequent elution. Interact only weakly with other macromolecule to minimize non-specific adsorption. So, we get pure purification of a protein properly. Moreover, it should exhibit good flow properties, which will enhance the chromatographic technique, eventually purification technique. In practice, particles that are uniform, spherical and rigid are used. Most common are cross-linked dextrine and agarose, polyacrylamide, polymethacrylate, polystyrene, cellulose and porous glass and silica, which are most widely used matrices in affinity chromatography. We'll discuss about ligand. It is the most important another important component used in affinity chromatography. The chemical nature of ligand is dependent upon the biological specificity of the compound to be purified. In practice, it is sometimes possible to select ligand that displays absolute specificity in that it will bind exclusively to one particular compound. More commonly, it is possible to select ligand that displays group selectivity in that it will bind to closely related group of compounds that possess a similar inbuilt chemical specificity. An example of later type of ligand is 5-AMP, which can bind reversibly to many NAD positive dependent dehydrogenase because it is structurally similar to part of NAD plus molecule. It is essential that ligand possess suitable chemical group that will not be involved in reversible binding of ligand to the molecule, but which can be used to attach ligand to the matrices. Most common such groups are amino group, carboxyl group, sulfyl group, and phenolic and alcoholic group. Different types of ligand used in affinity chromatography are nucleotides. For example, we use 5-AMP and it can be used for separation of NAD plus dependent dehydrogenase and some kinases. 2-5-ADP can be used for separation of NADP plus dependent hydrogenases. Calmodulin ligand can be used for separation of camodulin binding enzymes, that is calcium binding enzymes. Avidin can be used for biotin containing enzyme. Fatty acid can be used for fatty acid binding proteins. Heparin can be used for separation of lipoprotein, lipase, coagulation factors, DNA polymerase, steroid receptors, growth factors, serine protease inhibitors. Similarly, protein A and protein G, which has got high affinity for immunoglobulin, can be used for separation of Ig molecules. Cavnevalin A can be used for separation of glycoproteins containing alpha-D-menopyranosyl and alpha-D-glucopyranosyl residue. Soyabean lecithin can be used for separation of glycoprotein containing an acetyl alpha or beta D galactopyranosyl residue. Phenyl boronate can be used for separation of glycoproteins. Poly A tail can be used for separation of RNA containing poly U sequence. Some RNA specific proteins, lysine, which has got high affinity for rRNA, can be used for separation of RNA, rRNA molecules. Sibacaran blue, F3GA, can be used for nucleotide requiring enzymes and coagulation factors. These are examples of different types of ligands for separation of different affinity molecules in affinity chromatographic technique. Now we'll discuss about spacerum, though it is not required in all the chromatographic technique. However, it is used to prevent the attachment of ligand to matrices interfering with its ability to bind macromolecule, and it is present between ligand and the matrix. The optimal length of spacer arm is 6 to 10 carbon atom or their equivalent. Spacer arm are either purely hydrophobic, most commonly consisting of methylene group, or hydrophilic group possessing carbonyl or amido groups are other spacer arm. Spacer are most important for small immobilized ligand, but are generally not required for macromolecular ligand as the ligand binding site for mobile macromolecule is well displaced from the matrices. Several supports of agarose, dextrin, polyacrylamide type are commercially available with variety of spacer arm and ligand pre-attached ready for immediate use. These are the three main components of affinity chromatography used. Now we'll discuss practically how we can elute, how we can perform this experiment. Column containing matrices attached with spacer arm and immobilized ligand is equilibrated with mobile phase. Later, enzyme which you need to separate from the mixture should be passed through the affinity column. This will allow enzyme to bind to ligand and all other unwanted material or those who do not have affinity for ligand will be moving with the mobile phase. Now this enzyme which is bound to ligand will be eluted from column by using two methods. One is affinity elution and another is non-specific elution. We'll discuss first affinity elution. Affinity elution is a molecule which has got higher affinity for enzyme than ligand. On passing of this molecule in column, enzyme will bind to affinity molecule and they will be eluted from the ligand and it will be collected in mobile phase. Subsequently, by dialysis, purified enzyme or protein can be obtained. Similarly, elution can be performed with non-specific elution technique. In this method, instead of applying affinity molecule, we change pH or ionic concentration of the mobile phase, which will bring about change in the binding condition for. Another technique is non-specific elution, like affinity elution. Here, we do not use specific molecule, rather we change pH or ionic concentration. The change in pH and ionic concentration will change the binding condition. As a result, enzyme will be eluted from the ligand and later conditions can be restored to obtain purified enzymes. This is about how affinity chromatography is performed. Now we'll discuss about where this technique can be useful. Applications of affinity chromatography. Firstly, this technique was used for purification of enzymes. Many enzymes and other proteins, including receptor proteins and immunoglobulins, have been purified by affinity chromatography. Later, the same principle has been extended to purify nucleic acids, which led to considerable contribution in the development of molecular biology. For instance, messenger RNA is routinely isolated by selective hybridization on poly-U-sapharose-4B by exploiting its poly-A tail. Immobilized single-stranded DNA can be used to isolate complementary RNA and DNA. This separation can be achieved on columns. It is usually performed using single-stranded DNA immobilized on nitrocellulose paper. Immobilized nucleotides are useful for isolation of protein involved in nucleic acid metabolism. It can be also used to purify and concentrate substance from mixture into a buffering solution. Buffering solution reduces the amount of substances in mixture. It can be used for any biological compound binding to particular substance. It can be used to purify and concentrate an enzyme solution.